These are all a bunch of synthesizers, analog synthesizers. Number one on the list is the Korg Minilog. It's a polyphonic analog synthesizer. It's four voices. My first analog synth that I bought. But when I did first get it, I wasn't really feeling it too much. I couldn't really get the sounds that I wanted out of it. And this is kind of going back to what we were just talking about before. As soon as I connected the Afterneath and the Dig into it, that's when I was like, all of a sudden, this, why didn't I try this before? This is the sound that I wanted. A lot of early Yellow Rainbow stuff. Basically, like all my past releases, I'm working mostly in software, mostly software synthesizers. So not really like hands-on like a true analog synthesizer is. In my last release, I had the Minilog on maybe a couple of the tracks here and there, but still most of what I was using was software synthesizers, field recordings, and some guitar too. So that's when I started really using the Minilog a lot more. When I actually figured out how I can get the kind of sound I wanted out of it. I think what made me first get it is because I wanted something that was more hands-on. I guess there was part of me that was slowly breaking out of that computer realm. Basically like wondering, is there a world outside of the computer? The early stuff was Sounds of Reason, actually. Propellerhead Reason. I would say my first two releases. Then I got Logic. I didn't only just use them as DAWs, I used them like for their actual software synths that came either within the DAW itself or I purchased like plugins and stuff. And I'm excited to really put out something new with my like everything I'm doing on the channel. It's kind of a very different approach compared to like my past releases, and I'm excited for my next release because I think it actually might sound pretty different.